Hello guys, and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to talk about the classification of animals on the basis of their symmetry as well as on the basis of number of germ layers jo ki unki body mein present hote hain. Right? So, first criteria is going to be symmetry. Whether the organism is asymmetric, whether it is bilaterally symmetrical or radially symmetrical. So, let's talk about that. So the first thing is asymmetric organisms. For example, there is an irregular shape, right? This irregular shape cannot be divided into two equal halves by any of the plane. आप कोई irregular चीज है उसको आप किसी भी plane से दो equal half में divide करने की कोशिश करोगे तो नहीं कर पाओगे. And those things are obviously known as asymmetrical things. So these organisms are asymmetrical, and the examples are most of the sponges, that is the organisms belonging to the phylum Porifera. जो सबसे simplest organisms हैं animal kingdom के, that are poriferans, वो mostly asymmetric होते हैं. After that, there is bilaterally symmetrical. Bi simply means two. It means that any of the organism, okay, let's say this is an organism which can be divided into two equal halves only with the help of one plane. सिर्फ एक ही ऐसा plane होगा जिससे division करने पर दो equal halves हमें मिलेंगे. That kind of symmetry is known as bilaterally symmetrical. There cannot be other plane passing through center that can divide the individual into two equal halves. Right? So there is only a single plane which is passing through the center of mass and it is dividing the individual into two equal halves. So that is known as the bilaterally symmetrical. Okay? And most of the organisms are bilaterally symmetrical. Radial, it means that all the planes passing through the centers, right? Center se pass hone wale sare planes ek individual ko do equal halves mein divide kar denge. For example, if there is a spherical organism, then any of the plane passing through the center can divide it into two equal halves. So this is also going to be one half. This is also two equal parts, two equal parts, two equal parts. So any of the plane can divide the individual into two equal halves. This type of symmetry is known as radially symmetrical organisms, such as coelenterata, ctenophora, and the most important one, echinoderms. Okay, echinoderms, both bilateral and radial symmetry is shown in different stages of life cycle. Agar aap baat kare ek larva ki, then the larva of echinoderms is bilaterally symmetrical. But when we talk about the adult organism, it is going to be radially symmetrical. So we used to take the example of echinoderms in radially symmetrical organisms. And except all these, all the animals are bilaterally symmetrical. So we are done with Porifera, Coelenterata, Ctenophora. So here there is Platyhelminthes, Aschelminthes, Annelida, Arthropoda, Echinodermata, then Hemichordata and Chordata. All these things are going to be the proper examples of bilaterally symmetrical organisms. So in asymmetric, there is no plane which can divide the individual into two equal halves, that is sponges, most of the sponges. After that, bilaterally symmetrical, only a single plane can divide the organism into two equal halves. Then radially symmetrical, any of the plane passing through the center will divide the individual into two equal halves. And what is the benefit of radially symmetric organisms? Let us consider an organism having mouth over here. Okay, these are the pores, or this can be any kind of outlet or inlet which is serving as mouth. Okay, so if you are dividing this organism via this plane, then both of the individuals will be containing mouth. Lekin humne kaha ki koi bhi plane, any of the plane dividing that individual will create equal halves and similar halves having similar organs. It means that there are multiple sites from which the food can be taken inside. Right? It is obvious. If you are dividing a particular organism in many planes, it means that the organs are also present in many planes. So if you will cut an organism via any single plane, equal amount of organs will be distributed. ओके इसका मतलब पॉरी इसका मतलब ये जो है रेडियली सिमेट्रिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स इनमें पहले से वो चीज प्रेजेंट है कि ये काफी सारी जगह से फूड ले सकते हैं राइट एंड दैट इज अ मेजर अडेप्टेशन और इस तरीके से थोड़े ज्यादा एडवांस माने जाते हैं ओके सो वी आर क्लियर विद बायलेटरल रेडियल एंड वी आर क्लियर विद एसिमेट्रिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स नाउ ड्यूरिंग द डेवलपमेंट प्रोसेस ऑफ एन एनिमल द ऑर्गन्स यूज टू डेवलप फ्रॉम डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ जर्म लेयर्स ओके आप लोगों ने सुना होगा ये पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन मीजोडर्मल इन ओरिजन है ये पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन एक्टोडर्मल इन ओरिजन है सो दोज मीजोडर्म एक्टोडर्म एंडोडर्म आर नथिंग बट जर्म लेयर्स एंड दोज जर्म लेयर्स विल गिव राइज टू डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ ऑर्गन्स सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दोज जर्म लेयर्स द नंबर ऑफ जर्म लेयर्स दे कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू डिप्लोब्लास्टिक एंड ट्रिप्लोब्लास्टिक ऑर्गेनिजम्स डिप्लो वेयर डाय सिंपली मींस टू इट मींस दैट two different type of germ layers are present triplo simply means tri that is three it means that three different type of germ layers are formed let us take the diagram for a better view right this is the central cavity after that there is one layer there is another layer there is another layer so the outermost as the name indicates outer simply means ecto so this is going to be the ectoderm Now here there is some kind of space. In this space, an undifferentiated layer. This word is very important. Undifferentiated layer is present, which is known as mesoglia. Right? So there is outer ectoderm, then there is mesoglia, and after that there is the most internal layer that is endoderm. In this particular case, you can note a thing that the ectoderm is present, the endoderm is present, but the mesoderm is not present. Mesoderm ki jagah par ek undifferentiated layer hai that is known as mesoglia. In the next diagram, there is endoderm, there is ectoderm, and there is a yellowish layer shown here that is the mesoderm. So this particular thing is the diagram of diploblastic organisms. And this particular thing represents triploblastic organisms. So all the organs in lower animals are derived from endoderm and ectoderm. And all the organs in higher animals are derived from endoderm, ectoderm and mesoderm as well. So the examples are porifera, coelenterata, ctenophora, right? The lower organisms. From platyhelminthus, all the remaining ones are triploblastic. So who is the first triploblastic animal from phylum platyhelminthus or platyhelminthus and ki flatworms ke baad all the animals are having three different kind of germ layers that is ectoderm mesoderm and endoderm right and as the name indicate the endoderm will be present in inside and the ectoderm will be present on the outside so in this particular lecture we have taken two most important criteria to divide animals into different kind of categories the first one is symmetry asymmetric porifera then radially symmetrical ctenophora coelenterata and echinodermata then bilaterally symmetrical all rest of the animals in case of germ layers there is diploblastic organization triploblastic organization diploblastic will be containing endoderm ectoderm and an undifferentiated layer called as mesoglia in case of triploblastic there endoderm ectoderm and mesoderm So here the examples are Porifera, Coelenterata, Ctenophora and from Platyhelminthus onwards all of them are containing three different type of germ layers aur us hisab se inki jo hai classification ki jati hai So you can easily notice something that in last lecture also we have talked about some criteria most of the things are already clear from this because we are learning examples also So when somebody will ask you about Porifera you can tell that yes most of the poriferas are asymmetrical and they are having diploblastic type of organization right and in the last lecture we have talked about the organization level so you can say that yes there is cell aggregate system so dheere dheere hum jis tarike se criteria ko follow karte ja rahe hain us hisab se most of the characters are already done hame kis cheez par focus karna hai peculiar characteristics pe बिल्कुल स्पेसिफिक जो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक है जो कहीं नहीं पाए जाते। फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर इज वॉटर कैनाल सिस्टम, देर इज वॉटर वस्कुलर सिस्टम, देर आर फ्लीम सेल्स, देर आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्पेसिफिक प्रॉपर्टीज विच आर प्रेजेंट ओनली इन अ सिंगल फाइलम, उस चीज पर हमें फोकस करना है। फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर हम खुद की बात करें, वी आर कॉर्डेट्स, देन वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट नोटोकॉर्ड, नर्व कॉर्ड, फेरेंजियल गिल स्लिट्स, पोस्ट एनल टेल्स इन दैट पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर। सो हम क्या करेंगे, धीरे धीरे इंडिविजुअल्स की जैसे बात करते जाएंगे उस हिसाब से उनके पेक्यूलियर फीचर्स को पकड़ना जरूरी है, क्योंकि क्वेश्चन वहीं से आएगा। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग द क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम मेसोग्लिया एंड द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दिस, ये क्वेश्चन आने के पूरे पूरे चांसेस हैं। यू हैव टू मेमोराइज बोथ ऑफ दिस थिंग्स वेरी केयरफुली। सो थैंक यू सो मच गाइज फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो, शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स, सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन फॉर श्योर। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कीप सपोर्टिंग।